Hi, welcome back to Scholar's Point. Today I am going to explain you Law of Variable Proportions. Law of Variable Proportions can be explained in two terms, with the help of TP and with the help of MP. Full form of TP is total product. It can also be said as total physical product, and for MP, marginal product or marginal physical product. I am going to explain you in both the terms. So what does this law say? According to this law, if we go on using more and more units of variable factor with a fixed factor, what I have said? Variable factor with a fixed factor. Before explaining this law, I want to explain you variable factor and fixed factor. Variable factors are those factors whose application changes with the change in output, like labor. Labor can be increased or decreased to increase output or decrease output. And what about fixed factor? Fixed factors are those factors whose application does not change with change in output. Land can be the example. Machinery can also be the example. So what happens when we increase variable factor with the fixed factor? If we see in terms of TP, it will increase at increasing rate, then it will increase at diminishing rate, and then it will fall. I use the term here increases at increasing rate. Now what is this increasing rate? That means the rate of increase is increasing continuously. How can we show this in diagram? If we are saying that increases at increasing rate, then we will draw the curve in this manner. This is increasing rate. And after that, what happens? It will increase at diminishing rate. The rate of increase is diminishing. Diminishing means reducing. Then the curve will be like this. Both are going upward, but this is going this way and this is going this way. So it was increasing rate and it is diminishing rate. After that, TP falls, then it will go down. And if we explain this law in terms of MP, then first of all MP will increase, then it will decrease, but it will remain positive, and after that it becomes negative. I told you there are three stages of law of variable proportions. First stage, second stage, third stage. Name of the first stage is increasing returns to a factor, because in this stage MP increases. And the second is diminishing returns to a factor, because in this stage MP decreases. And the third is negative returns, because in this stage MP becomes negative. So let's understand this law with the help of table and diagram. Here we will take units of land, that is the fixed factor, then units of labor. What is this? This is variable factor, I told you. And after that, TP and then MP. What happens here? I told you, when we increase the units of variable factor with the fixed factor, that means fixed factor will not change, it will remain same. See here, it is same. And we are increasing now variable factor. See, I am increasing. Here you are seeing fixed factor is same and variable factor is increasing. So when we increase variable factor with the fixed factor, I told you what happens to TP. It is difficult to learn the table. So what I have done, I will write first MP. Start from 2. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, then go back. 3, 2, 1, 0, minus 4. It will be easy for you to understand this table in this way. And you all know how we can find TP from MP. How we can find? First of all, this 2 will be here, 2, and 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 1, 15, 15 plus 0, 15, 15 plus minus means it will be minus 1, 40. So there is no need to learn TP. You can write MP. That was easy to learn. You can start counting. First forward counting and then make it reverse. Then you, with the help of MP, you can find TP. Your table will be ready. Now what happens here? I said first, in first stage, MP will increase. See here, till 4, MP is increasing. So this is the first stage. Increasing returns to a factor, because here MP is increasing and TP is increasing at increasing rate. MP is the rate of TP. Here MP is increasing, so TP is increasing at increasing rate. After that, you are seeing that MP is decreasing, but till here it is positive. So this is the second stage, diminishing returns to a factor. Here TP is increasing at diminishing rate. Here you are seeing it is still increasing, but at diminishing rate. After that, you can see that MP becomes negative. Then it is the third stage, negative returns. So we have explained all the three stages of law of variable proportions with the help of this table. Now we will use the diagram to explain this. See how we will make. First of all, here we will show TP and here we will show MP. This is the x-axis and this is y-axis. Here you will show units of labor, the variable factor. Here also. Now, what I told you, in the first stage, what will happen to TP? TP will increase at increasing rate. And whenever anything is increased at increasing rate, its curve will be like this. And when it increases at diminishing rate, then its curve will be like this. So I will draw with the help of this. First I said TP will increase at increasing rate. See, I have drawn this. Till here it is increasing at increasing rate. After that, increases at diminishing rate. See, its direction changed. Now after this stage, TP will fall. This is the TP curve now. See, I have used this concept. Increasing rate, till here it is increasing rate. And till here it is diminishing rate. And after that it falls. This is the TP curve. And we will extend this to this diagram. See what happens in the first stage. What happened to MP? MP increases. So this is the first stage. okay? This is the first stage. In this stage, MP will increase. See, MP is going upward, so it is increased. After that, in second stage, MP will decrease, but remember, it will be positive. It will remain positive. So, till here, we have to draw this MP curve. See here, it is positive. And in third stage, what I told you, MP will become negative. So, draw like this. This is your MP curve. Here it is increasing, here it is decreasing, but positive, and here it becomes negative. And here TP is maximum. In this diagram, there is one more point, K. This is point of inflection. Point of inflection shows the changing slope of TP. Earlier TP was increasing at increasing rate, and after that it was increasing at diminishing rate. The turning point is known as point of inflection. Okay, and here the TP is maximum. When TP is maximum, MP is zero. When TP falls, MP becomes negative. Okay, this shows relationship also between TP and MP. So we have understood well law of variable proportions. I hope you understand. If you like my video, please share, subscribe, and like. Thank you for watching my video.